So my second shot wound up just off the green. So the question now is, should I chip it or should I putt it? Well, I'll be happy to answer that question for you a little later today on Winning Golf.
It's in the hole!
Winning golf, that's what it's you in the play.
Wow!
Working on that short game each and every
just
day.
Just got a chance!
Oh. I'm near the green again, that's where the action all begins. Cause with Winning Golf, everybody wins.
That's right.
Everybody wins.
Hi everyone, and welcome to Winning Golf, the show where everybody wins. And today, Winning Golf comes to you from the beautiful White Clay Creek Country Club. And joining me as our host today from Belfour Restoration is my very good friend, Daryl Tuno. And Daryl, first of all, welcome back to Winning Golf. And Daryl, today we have a great venue, great prizes to give away, a great group of guests. Daryl, I believe that combination is the perfect recipe for some winning golf.
Well, no matter the outcome today for you guys, with this weather, we're all going to be winning at golf. Thank you, Doug.
Looking forward to it.
You're
quite welcome, Daryl. Well, guys, let me start the show with a simple question. Are you ready to play some winning golf?
Yeah! Oh,
I love your enthusiasm. Well, Kevin Powell has been selected for our first skills challenge, and Kevin, here's your contest. We have placed three rings around the cup, 10 feet, 6 feet, and 3 feet. I'm going to give you a 20-foot putt, Kevin. If you wind up in the 10-foot circle, I'm going to give you a beautiful 62-inch winning golf umbrella. If you wind up in a 6-foot circle, I'm going to give you a dozen Titleist Pro V1s. Now, Kevin, if you're really hot today and your putter's on fire and you wind up in that 3-foot circle, you're going to add a beautiful Titleist Smoky wedge to your bag. How's that sound? Pretty awesome prizes?
Sounds great.
Now, any questions, Kevin?
What happens if I roll it in, Doug?
Kevin, that's a great question. If you roll it in, I'm going to give you all three prizes. How's that sound?
Sounds great.
Pretty awesome, guys?
Yeah.
All right. Let's get ready to putt. Kevin Powell has a 20-foot putt with a chance to win a great prize, or maybe even three great prizes if he rolls it in. Well, Kevin has a nice setup. He's 20 feet, and here it comes. Got a good roll. It's through the first one, through the second one, and he's in the 6-foot circle. What a great putt by Kevin Powell. Well, Kevin Powell, congratulations. That smooth putting stroke just won you a dozen Titleist Pro V1s. Well done, my friend. Hey, I hope you enjoyed the contest.
Doug, I had a great time. It was awesome.
Awesome. Well, as you can see, this Belfour Restoration team knows how to play some winning golf. And the great news is this, we still have lots of exciting contests ahead of us. But first, let's take a tour around today's host facility, one of the top country clubs in the state of Delaware, the spectacular White Clay Creek Country Club. One thing is for sure, it's easy to spend an entire day at White Clay Creek Country Club. You can begin your day with an enjoyable round of golf, follow that up with a delicious meal in the award-winning Rail Wine Bar and Grill. And if you weren't so lucky earlier on the golf course, you can trot next door and try your luck at Delaware Park. White Clay Creek Country Club, a public facility with a private mentality, is known throughout the area as a first-class venue for food, golf, banquets, wedding receptions, and corporate meetings. The banquet team provides unique catering packages and would love to be part of your wedding reception, employee gathering, or any other special celebration. The spacious clubhouse banquet room overlooks the picturesque fairways and can accommodate up to 250 seated guests. The professional and service-oriented golf staff offers a fully stocked golf shop, club fitting, private lessons, adult clinics and junior camps, as well as a golf course that's always in pristine condition.
Our conditions here at White Clay Creek mirror are better than, in my opinion, most people in the area. I think that our practice facility is first class, and the conditions on the range, short game area, are equal to what you see on the golf course.
The Arthur Hills design course is challenging and demands superior course management, with water entering the picture on 15 of the 18 holes. Although reaching 7,000 yards from the tips and earning a 140 slope rating, White Clay Creek offers 5 sets of tees, allowing players of all abilities to enjoy their experience. With the unique variety of holes, impeccable conditions from tee to green, and nature surrounding you at every turn, it's a golf course that draws you back time and time again.
Not only open to the public, but we have memberships here, different flexible memberships where if you want a 5-day membership or a 7-day membership, maybe even a twilight membership. But then more importantly, we also have corporate outings, charity outings. So we feel like we're a destination area where you can play golf in an outing, you can be a member here, or go visit Delaware Park in the casino and have fun over there.
Another special feature that separates White Clay Creek from most venues is its remarkable practice facility. White Clay Creek provides a 60,000 square foot natural bent grass tee box, a 7,500 square foot bent grass putting green, and two separate 5,000 square foot short game greens, all in impeccable condition.
Our practice facility here at White Clay Creek Country Club is fantastic. We have a very, very large bent grass tee to hit from. We also have two short game greens where you can practice bunker, pitching anywhere from about 30 to about 70 yards long.
White Clay Creek also provides a state-of-the-art indoor training facility.
We have a great practice facility indoor. It's about a 900 square foot studio where we use FlightScope for our launch monitor. We also use V1 as our video swing analysis. So we can bring someone in, do club fittings, do a swing analysis, and then send that to them so that they can see that for future, and then bring them back in for a follow-up lesson down the road.
White Clay Creek is easily accessible from I-95. Just look for the Churchman's Road exit. From there, just follow signs for Delaware Park. For more information on tee times, unique membership packages, junior camps, golf outings, weddings, or corporate meetings, please call 302-994-6700 or check out the website at whiteclaycreek.com.
Get ready for the Winning Golf Skills Challenge. Winning golf, where everybody wins. Now, let's meet our players. Dan McVay, Mike Adiani, Jake Mello, Dave McFarland, Mike McDevitt, Kevin Powell, Neil Killian, Mike Barrow, Ed Hoenicki, Rick Miramontes. Our players are set for Doug's FootJoy Lesson Tip and Shoe Contest. FootJoy, the mark of a player.
Fellas, today's FootJoy contest comes to you in three parts. Part number one, I'm going to show you how to apply a putting stroke to your 8-iron. Part number two, Dan McVay is going to put my lesson tip in action. And part three is the FootJoy contest, where all of you will get to try to putt with your 8-iron. At the same time, compete for an unbelievable prize. You guys ready for this? How about a gorgeous pair of FootJoy shoes? The number one shoe in golf. Isn't that awesome?
Yeah.
What a prize. So the question I have for you today is this. If your ball is just off the green like this one, should you chip it or putt it? Well, I will tell you, in my case, every time I would chip this, but I know many of my students and many of you would probably choose the putting option. So today I'm going to compromise. I'm going to let you putt it, but we're going to putt it with an 8-iron. Sound good, guys?
Absolutely.
Yeah.
All right. So here's my stroke and my setup when I'm putting with my 8-iron. The first thing I do is I apply my putting grip to the 8-iron. The second thing I do is I play my ball a little bit front and middle of my stance. The third thing I do is take my weight and bump it into my front hip. And the fourth thing is very important. I want to get my eyes over the golf ball, fellas, just like what I do when I'm putting. The problem is the 8-iron's a lot longer than my putter. So to make that happen, I have to choke down on the golf club. That will allow me to move closer and get my eyes over the golf ball. Can you see my eyes now over it? It also lets my shaft become more upright, like a putter shaft. If we have the shaft like this, the heel of the club will often hit the ground first and you'll chunk the shot. So by choking down, we can move closer, get the eyes over the golf ball, and get the shaft more upright. And that leads us to the stroke. The stroke is like your putting stroke. I want you to take it back and through with your arms and shoulders, not your wrists. So we're using arms and shoulders and we're literally putting this ball with an 8-iron. If you do that, the ball will jump up here a few feet and then run the rest of the way to the hole. Sound good, guys?
Yeah.
Awesome. Well, I'd love for Dan McVay to come up here before our contest starts. Dan, welcome. All right, Dan, so let me put you through the setup. The first thing you want to do is apply your putting grip to that 8-iron. The second thing I want you to do is play that ball front of middle. So that's pretty good right there. Let me move that ball back for you. That's front and middle. Okay, the third thing I want you to do is bump a little weight into that front hip. Excellent. Now, let's choke down on that club a little bit. And that should get your eyes over the golf ball. That's excellent. And your shaft more upright. All right. Now the stroke, I want you to take a stroke with just your arms and shoulders, okay? So we're gonna go back and through. Let's try one practice stroke, okay? Get back and through with your arm and shoulders, no wrist. Excellent. You ready to go?
I am.
I'm gonna step back with this wonderful Belfour restoration team when you're ready. Let's put a nice parting stroke on this 8-iron. Look at this shot, everybody. What a beautiful touch.
Go!
That's a beautiful stroke with your 8-iron, my friend. I hope you learned a lot.
I did, Doug. Thank you. That was a great tip.
You're quite welcome. Hey, guys, you ready to try to win a pair of FootJoy shoes?
Yeah!
Let's do it.
For your private or group golf instruction with PGA Golf Professional Doug Hendricks, go to winninggolftv.com or send an email to doug@rdhgolf.com. Now let's see if Doug's tip helps our players as they battle it out for the prize. Our FootJoy contest is a 35-foot chip shot from just off the green. Dan McVeigh applies Doug's tip well.
Well done, Dan. Good job.
Rick Miramontes looks to take the round.
Great setup and a beautiful touch. Well done, Rick. Nice job.
Mike Barrow's effort looks good at less than 7 feet from the pin.
Right towards the hole. That just passed the cut. Well done, Mike.
Neil Killian is a foot closer.
That's rolling tight to the hole. Well done, Neil.
But Kevin Powell hits this tremendous winning golf shot to take the shoes.
And a beautiful stroke. Well done, Kevin. Well done.
Coming up, our skills challenge begins, and one of our players will putt for a new Buick Encore GX. Winning Golf will be right back.
At FootJoy, we know a little something about the ground. It's unpredictable. Up, down, slippery, sticky, firm, squishy. There is no telling how it will act. But with a little extra traction and stable footing, one needn't give a thought to the ground's fickle mood. We know what it takes for stability, traction, and comfort. For the love of golf.
Dinner with the Drakes tonight? Alexa, ask Buick to start my Encore GX. Four fillets.
You know this dinner's for their
kids. Thanks for watching them.
Where's the pizza?
The first ever Buick Encore GX. Current eligible Buick lessees get this low mileage lease on this 2020 Buick Encore GX for around $179 per month.
Prizes and tee gifts for the Winning Golf Skills Challenge provided by Bag Boy Travel Covers. Bag Boy, the details make the difference. Ahead Advanced Headwear, embroidery and design. Ahead. And PJ Wheelahan's Pub and Restaurant. Visit one of our restaurants for indoor or outdoor dining and takeout. PJ Wheelahan's. Doug Hendricks Wardrobe provided by the Greg Norman Collection. Greg Norman, performance by design.
Everybody wins.
Welcome back to Winning Golf. It's time now for our Scotty Cameron Challenge. Scotty Cameron Putters, the choice of champions.
Welcome back to Winning Golf. Well, guys, in our next thrilling event, one of you could win a Scotty Cameron Putter. How's that sound?
Yeah!
All right, here's the deal. Our terrific host, Daryl Tuno, will pull one name out of the hat. That player will then have two chances from only 10 feet to roll in a putt to win a Scotty Cameron Putter. So, fellas, needless to say, this is going to be very exciting. Speaking of exciting, Daryl, who's our lucky contestant today here at the beautiful White Clay Creek Country Club? Daryl, please, the guys are getting antsy. Who's our lucky contestant? Somebody's gonna get to roll in a putt for a
Mike
Scotty.
Barrow.
Mike Barrow! Mike, come on up here, my friend. All right, here's the deal. You get two chances from 10 feet, you roll one in. I hand you a Scotty Cameron putter. You up for the challenge?
Absolutely.
Awesome, let's do it. Okay, Mike Barrow has two chances to roll in a 10-foot putt. If successful, Mike will add a Scotty Cameron putter to his bag, just like I did this season. Here it comes from 10 feet. What a setup, what a putt. Oh, just over the lip. Well, the good news is he's got a mulligan. A little bit left to right, and here's the putt. Oh, just over the right edge. What a great try by Mike Barrow. Well, Mike, that was a great effort. You gave both putts a chance. You didn't win the putter, but I still hope you had some fun.
Great time. Wish it went in, though.
All right, thank you, Michael. Well, we didn't give away the Scotty Cameron putter this week, but the great news is this. We still have lots of exciting prizes to give away in the Winning Golf Skills Challenge. So let's get round one underway.
Our Winning Golf Skills Challenge will showcase our competitors' short game skills with some challenging shots in three preliminary rounds. If they win a round, they win a prize and valuable extra shots in our all-important Survivor Round. Our top two winners in the Survivor Round will compete in an up-and-in competition to determine this week's champion. Round one features a 40-foot downhill chip shot from the heavy rough. Mike McDevitt is up to the challenge.
And a nice roll. Well done, Mike. Good job.
Jake Mello chips this shot to 5 feet from the pin.
This one's got a chance. Jake Mello, oh, right over the lip. What an effort by Jake Mello.
Dan McVay's ball dances an inch closer.
And this is going to be a nice touch by Dan. Well done, Dan.
Mike Barrow's effort looks good at 4 feet.
This could be very close, right behind the cup. What a touch by Mike.
But Ed Hoenicki hits a gem to about 2 feet to take the round.
Ed Hoenicki with a pitching wedge. Look at this touch by Ed. That is winning golf, Ed. Well done.
Round two is a 30-yard uphill pitch that Rick Miramontes handles well.
Nice touch by Rick. Well done, buddy.
Jake Mello continues his fine play.
This one's got a chance. My goodness, what a touch by Jake.
Dave McFarland is the first to 5 feet away.
With a 56-degree wedge, and look at his touch by Dave. That is winning golf.
Kevin Powell pitches it beautifully to about 3 feet.
And look at this touch by Kevin. That is winning golf. Well done.
But check out Neil Killian's shot to just 10 inches.
Look at this touch by Neil. That's got a chance. Wow.
He takes the round. Round three is our putting contest. Jake Mello tackles this 25-footer with ease.
Won't get there, that's the question. Good job.
Mike Adiani has a smooth stroke.
The speed looks good, and that is pin high. What an effort by Mike.
Mike McDevitt's effort looks good at a foot and a half.
Moving from right to left, that is pin high. Look at that touch by Mike. Good job.
Rick Miramontes has a nice roll.
A beautiful setup and a beautiful stroke. Well done, Rick.
Ed Hoenicki puts it with style.
It's a beautiful stroke by Ed, and that is pin high. Well done, Ed.
Dave McFarland sets the mark to beat at 1 foot.
Dave McFarland with a nice setup. It's got a chance. Oh, my goodness.
No problem for Mike Barrow.
With a beautiful stroke, it's got a chance. Mike Barrow right on the doorstep.
At 1 inch, he easily takes the round. Now it's time to check out what's on the tee with PGA professional Doug Hendricks. Brought to you by Thermal Solutions, a dynamic mechanical insulation contractor presently celebrating 15 years of excellence. Thermal Solutions.
On the tee today, I would like to discuss the importance of selecting a specific target whenever hitting a shot around the green. Now please note, a specific target is not the cup or the pin. It's the point where you want your ball to land so you wind up near the cup or the pin. So here's my three-step routine I have whenever I'm hitting a chip or pitch shot around the green. Step number one is I read the green just like I read a putt. Step number two is I pick out my specific target or my landing area. In this case, it's a red ring about 15 feet in front of me. My third step is to pick the right club. I want to pick a club that if I hit my landing area with the roll, it will wind up near the pin. So let's give it a try. I've picked the sand wedge. My circle is in front of me. Let's see if I can drop it in or near that circle, and we'll see what happens. Well, I think we'll take that one. So remember, whenever hitting a shot around the green, always select a specific target. I'll see you next week on the tee.
The top two players in our Winning Golf Skills Challenge Survivor Round will advance to compete in a one-on-one up-and-in competition to determine this week's champion. Players who've won previous rounds have extra shots to try to get closest to the cup. This week, our players are tested with this 25-yard downhill pitch that Mike McDevitt tamed with ease.
And that's 10 for the cup. That's a nice touch by Mike McDevitt.
Ed Hoenicki pitches it to 11 feet from the pin.
Ed Hoenicki with a pitching wedge. This one's got a chance. Ed Hoenicki, oh, just passed a lip. Great shot, Ed.
Neil Killian grabs the first spot in our final with this pitch.
And look at this touch by Neil. That is just behind the cup. Well done.
And Mike Barrow takes the round with this effort to just over 7 feet.
It's a beautiful setup. Rolling back towards the cup. And what a great touch by Mike Barrow.
So it will be Barrow and Killian to battle it out for the title of this week's champion when Winning Golf comes right back.
We asked the pros if we should change the Pro SL, the number one shoe in golf.
Never.
No, don't.
But you never settle, and neither do we. So we made the best shoe in the game even better. We added more comfort, traction, and performance. For every slope, lump, and bump, this game throws at your feet. And we made another option with carbon for off-the-charts stability and control. So why'd we change the Pro SL? Simple. For the love of golf.
Titleist T200, inspired by a tour look and feel. Powered by Max Impact. A striking innovation that spreads speed and control evenly across the forged base. Coupled with a modern shape for exceptional performance with a player's feel. Titleist T200, designed to help you score lower.
Prizes for winning golf contestants provided by Signs by the Sea, the best custom handmade golf accessories and gifts. Signs by the Sea. Vokey SM8 Wedges. Know your letter, hit your number. Vokey SM8 Wedges. And by Devant, the number one custom golf towel in the business. Devant. Outerwear provided by FootJoy. FootJoy Performance Outerwear. Layer up with FootJoy. It's now time for the Winning Golf Up and In Playoff.
We're on the practice green and our two finalists are ready to compete for some amazing prizes, a beautiful championship trophy, and the chance to drive home with the keys to a gorgeous Buick Encore GX. Now the rules for the Winning Golf Up and In Playoff are simple. Whoever gets their ball into the cup in the fewest number of strokes will be crowned our Winning Golf Champion. Our first shot in the Winning Golf Up and In Playoff will be a 20-yard downhill pitch from the heavy rough. Neil Killian will have the honors. Neil carries a 25 handicap and plays most of his golf at DuPont Country Club. Neil has chosen a pitching wedge. This is a delicate little shot. The rough is very heavy here. It's a nice little shot. Rolling down towards the cup. And that is a great effort under a lot of pressure and looks like about 6 feet from the hole. Well done. Now it's Mike Barrow's turn to try and battle this very challenging practice green here at the beautiful White Clay Creek Country Club. Mike owns a zero handicap. He's a scratch golfer, and he enjoys his golf at Newark Country Club. It's the first scratch golfer we've ever had on our show. He's chosen a sand wedge out of the heavy rough, and that's rolling from right to left, and you can see why he's a scratch golfer. That is about 2 feet from the hole. Well done, Mike Barrow. Well, Neil Killian is away, so he will have the honors and putt first. Well, Neil Killian has 6 feet a little bit up the hill. A good stroke, and it's, oh, just off to the right of the lip. Well, Mike Barrow has 3 feet to become the Winning Golf Champion here at the beautiful White Clay Creek Country Club. Let's see if he can roll it in. Right in the heart of the hole, and Mike Barrow is our Winning Golf Champion here at White Clay Creek Country Club. Congratulations, Mike. Well, Mike Barrow, congratulations on becoming the Winning Golf Champion here at the beautiful White Clay Creek Country Club. And Michael, you're the first scratch player we've ever had in 10 years on Winning Golf, and you certainly live up to your billing. You got up and down in two in the Winning Golf Up and In Playoff. That's what great champions do. I hope you enjoyed, Mike, your experience with Winning Golf.
Had a great day. Thank you, Doug and Winning Golf, for having us out. And especially thank you, Belfour Restoration, for inviting us out today.
Well, you're quite welcome. Now, Mike, your experience is not quite over yet, because in a couple minutes, I'm going to give you the opportunity to putt from only 60 feet for the keys to a gorgeous Buick Encore GX. Mike, do you have one more pressure putt in you?
Let's go see.
Well, I like your spirit, and we're certainly rooting for you. Well, I've got a great feeling about this next putt, so whatever you do, don't touch that remote. We'll be right back with more Winning Golf.
You'll never experience a hotel quite like the Desmond Malvern, a DoubleTree by Hilton. Now you can enjoy a fully renovated hotel with the same great service and staff, as well as our popular two on-site restaurants and pub. Our distinct banquet spaces can accommodate all sizes for any special occasion. The Desmond is also home to the only IACC-certified conference center in the area. The Desmond Malvern, a DoubleTree by Hilton, where you can get your Hilton Honor Points and a cookie, too.
With the Drakes tonight. Alexa, ask Buick to start my Encore GX. Four fillets.
You know this dinner's for their
kids. Thanks for watching them.
Where's the pizza?
The first ever Buick Encore GX. Current eligible Buick lessees get this low mileage lease on this 2020 Buick Encore GX for around $179 per month.
It's time on Winning Golf for the Champions Putt, sponsored by your Tri-State Buick GMC dealers. Check out the new Buick Encore GX at your Tri-State Buick GMC dealer.
Welcome back to Winning Golf for our final event, the Champions Putt. Each week, our Winning Golf champion will attempt a 60-foot putt to win a gorgeous Buick Encore GX. Winning Golf is very thankful to have the Tri-State Buick GMC dealer sponsoring this thrilling event. So let me set the stage. We're on the gorgeous putting green here at White Clay Creek Country Club. Today's Winning Golf champion, Mike Barrow, is only 60 feet away from the cup. If he can roll it in, Mike will win the keys and a two-year lease to a spectacular Buick Encore GX. So here it comes from 60 feet. Boy, the line looks good. This speed looks good. This one's tracking right towards the cup. And that is pin high, just off to the right. How about that effort from our champion, Mike Barrow? Well, I hope you enjoyed today's thrilling show from the stunning White Clay Creek Country Club. I would personally like to thank the entire White Clay Creek staff and membership for the warm welcome and amazing hospitality. Also, a big shout out to my wonderful host, Darryl Tuno, and his Belfour Restoration team for selecting a wonderful group of guests that not only can play some good golf, but also choose to serve us and keep us safe throughout the year. Thanks, guys, and thanks to all of you for watching Winning Golf. I'll see you next week.
Sticking one by the pin, I'm busting out a grin.